ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर। गुड
लेट्स स्टार्ट। सी, यस्टरडे वी हैड डिस्कस्ड एक्सियम्स, थर्ड डेफिनेशन ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज एक्सियम्स ऑफ एक्सियोमेटिक अप्रोच। देर आर थ्री एक्सियम्स। द फर्स्ट इज प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ any event is always greater than or equal to zero. Second axiom is probability of entire sample space is one. And third axiom is if a1, a2, an are mutually exclusive events, then probability of union of all events is equal to sum of their probabilities, right? Now, using those three axioms, we can actually derive or we can actually prove number of theorems, okay, out of which few theorems we have stated yesterday. Okay, now let us solve examples based on those three axioms and theorems of probability. Okay, now here is the first example. If A and B are any two events such that probability of occurrence of event A is 0.6, probability of B is 0.5, probability of A intersection B is 0.3, then find probability of A complement, probability of A union B, etc. Okay. Now, let us find first probability of A complement. Okay. A complement means what? Not A. Fine. Now, according to the first theorem of probability, it is equal to 1 minus probability of A. Okay, and we know the value of probability of A, that is 0.6. So it is equal to 1 minus 0.6, or it is equal to 0.4. Right? What about probability of A union B? Now here, we have to use addition theorem of probability. Okay, here we don't know whether events A and B are mutually exclusive. If they are, then this then probability of A union B is simply probability of A plus probability of B. But A union A and B may or may not be exclusive. Okay, so we'll use addition theorem, and it states that probability of A union B equals to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. Okay. क्या करना है ना, हमने जस्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यूज, यू विल गेट रिक्वायर्ड रिजल्ट। तो 0.6 प्लस 0.5 इज 1.1, माइनस 0.3 इज 0.8। ओके, नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल इज अ बिट इंटरेस्टिंग। See, here we are actually interested in probability of A intersection B complement. Okay. Means what? We want to find probability of A and not B. Okay. Matlab kya hoga? So we have to exclude those elements from A which are in B. Okay. I'll explain with the help of and Venn diagram. Suppose that this is a sample space omega. Okay. Event A and event B. Okay. Now, here we want to find probability of A intersection B complement. It means what? We want to find probability of this region. Okay. So this region is not. So, finding probability of A intersection B complement is nothing but finding probability of A minus probability of intersection B, right? Entire probability of A minus this region. This is nothing but the intersection of A and B, okay? Now, P of A is given, P of A intersection B is given. So, this probability is 0.6 minus 0.3, that is equal to 0.3. Okay. Similarly, what would be P of A complement intersection B?
Just a minute. I'll receive one call in important for.
Similarly, we can find probability of A complement intersection B. What is probability of A complement intersection B? We are actually interested in elements of B, but not A. Is what this region? Okay. So this is nothing but probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. Okay. So the required probability will be 0.5 minus 0.3, that is equal to 0.2. Okay. Okay. Now the last one. Probability of A complement union B complement. इसको कैसे फाइंड आउट करेंगे? ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट यूनियन बी कॉम्प्लीमेंट. ओके, सो व्हाट इज एक्चुअली ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट? ऑल एलिमेंट्स आउटसाइड ए, मतलब दिस एलिमेंट्स, ओके, which includes some elements of B. Okay. Similarly, B complement consists of those elements which are not in B. Okay. So I'll shade it like this. Right? Fine. It means that A complement union B complement includes all elements which are not in the intersection. Okay, it will include elements of A complement intersection B. It also include elements of this is what A intersection B complement, this is B intersection A complement, and outside. Okay. But instead of doing this using this complex process, we use De Morgan's law of set theory, which states that A union B, the whole complement, bracket complement, is equal to A complement intersection B complement. And the second version of De Morgan's law is A intersection B whole complement is equal to A complement union B complement. Okay. So here, probability of A complement union B complement is what? See, A complement union B complement is same as A intersection B complement. So this is equal to probability of, okay, I'll use two brackets, A intersection B complement. Okay. Now, we also know that probability of A complement equals to 1 minus probability of A. Okay. So probability of this bracket complement is equal to 1 minus probability of A intersection B. Right. So this probability is equal to 0.7. 1 minus 0.3 is 0.7. Okay. That's it. Hope you understand how I have calculated the given probabilities. Okay. Now let's discuss second example. Okay. I'll dictate the probability that a contractor, okay, please note down the question. The probability that a contractor will get a plumbing contract is 0.4. A probability of A equals to 0.4. Okay. So here I have defined event A as contract.
Sir, pardon the question, please. Sir.
Okay. The probability that a contractor will get a plumbing contract is 0.4. Okay. And the probability that he will not get electric contract is 0.7. Okay. If the probability of getting at least one contract is is 0.6. Question is, what is, in fact there are two questions, what is the probability that he will get both the contracts. And second question, exactly one contract. Okay. See, in previous question, the events were predefined, A and B. Okay. Ab yahan pe hame define karna padega. So let's define event A as contractor will get plumbing contract. Okay. And B be the event that he will get electric contract. Fine. Now what is given then? Probability of A is given. The probability that contractor will get plumbing contract is 0.4. Okay. Second sentence kya hai? The probability that he will not get electric contract. Not get. But humne B kya define kya hai? Here we have defined B as contractor will get electric contract. Correct. So the given probability is of what? 0.7.
B dash.
B dash, correct. It's complement of B, right? Aur kya diya yahan pe? If probability of getting at least one contract, matlab, at least means either A or B or both. Right, so which is nothing but probability of A union B. Okay, probability of A union B is 0.6. Fine, and find out kya karna hai? पहला क्वेश्चन बोथ द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स मतलब ए एंड बी. ओके सी इन सेट थ्योरी और मींस यूनियन. ओके और मींस यूनियन एंड मींस इंटरसेक्शन दोनों होने चाहिए ना. ए एज वेल एज बी मतलब कॉमन एलिमेंट है एंड कॉमन एलिमेंट इज डिनोटेड बाय दिस सिंबल और इंटरसेक्शन. ओके तो ये हमें फाइंड आउट करना है. सेकेंड क्वेश्चन क्या है एग्जैक्टली वन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट मतलब
ए प्लस बी माइनस ए इंटरसेक्शन बी.
ओके दैट विल गिव यू द यूनियन एग्जैक्टली वन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट ए और बी बट नॉट बोथ मतलब क्या है ए और बी ए यूनियन बी. ओके बट नॉट बोथ मीन्स माइनस ए इंटरसेक्शन बी. ओके सी लेट्स डिस्कस विद द हेल्प ऑफ वेन डायग्राम. सपोज दैट दिस इज ए एंड दिस इज बी. ओके फाइन नाउ इन सेकेंड क्वेश्चन वी आर एक्चुअली इंटरेस्टेड इन exactly one contract. Okay, means this portion, shaded portion. Okay. Now, ये क्या है actually? This is what? A union B. Whole is A union B. But ये हमें नहीं चाहिए. Okay. We are not interested in this. I mean, this is not required. So what we'll do? We'll take union of A and B and then subtract A intersection B from this. Fine. ओके समझ में आ गया. सो दिस इज व्हाट वी वांट टू ऑब्टेन इन दिस केस. ओके फाइन कैसे फाइंड आउट करेंगे इंटरसेक्शन. टू फाइंड इंटरसेक्शन विल यूज एडिशन थ्योरम ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी. प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ए यूनियन बी वेट डोंट राइट इट्स प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ए प्लस प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ बी माइनस प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ए इंटरसेक्शन बी. Okay, so say this is A union B is given, probability of A is given, probability of B is not given, but we can find probability of B. Probability of A intersection B, we know this, this and this. Okay. Now, given that probability of B complement equals to 0.7, okay, therefore 1 minus must be 0.7. So probability of B minus probability of B, right? 0.3. Okay. Now what we'll do? We'll substitute the values of A union B, probability of A union B, probability of A, probability of B in this equation. Okay. So what we get? 0.6 equals to 0.4 plus 0.3 minus probability of A intersection B. Okay. A simple algebraic operation hai. If you transpose this to the left hand side and 0.6 to the right hand side, what we get? Probability of A intersection B equals to 0.7 minus 0.6 is. Okay, so we have obtained this value. Second part, second question is here, right? Kya hoga? Equals to 0.6 minus intersection we have calculated 0.1, so this must be 0.5, right? Okay. एक और ट्राई करते हैं. ठीक है, अ सर्टन कंपनी एक्चुअली इजी है. ठीक है, लेट्स डू दिस. अ सर्टन कंपनी एनकरेजेस इट्स एम्प्लॉइज टू पार्टिसिपेट इन क्रिकेट एंड हॉकी. टू पार्टिसिपेट इन क्रिकेट एंड हॉकी. सर्वे इंडिकेट्स दैट 40% प्ले क्रिकेट. And 25% play cricket and hockey. Find the probabilities of first, an employee plays only hockey. Second, only cricket. Third, at least one of the two games. And fourth, does not play either of the two games. Okay. Okay. Now let's denote the group of people who plays cricket by C and hockey by H. Okay. So what is given? Probability of C is given, probability of H is given, or kya diya hai? Intersection is given. Whenever you write solution, you have to define events. Ab main yahan pe direct le raha hu. So kaise karenge event? Let C and H represent the event that randomly selected employee plays cricket and hockey respectively. Okay. Yeah, you can use any letter instead of C and H. You can use A, B or C, D. Kuch bhi le sakte, necessary nahi hai. But for the sake of convenience, I have used letter C and H. C stands for cricket, H stands for hockey. Okay. But you can use any letter. Fine. So kya diya hai? See, here probabilities are given in terms of percentage. Usually probabilities are given in terms of fraction, but here probabilities are given in terms of percentages. Okay, so we'll write in terms of fraction. It is given that 40% play cricket. So probability of C is 0.4. Then 50% play hockey, 0.5. Okay. And 25% play cricket and hockey, matlab both. Okay. Yahan pe ek cheez mein I would like to add. In fact, it is a you must have learned this concept in the high school itself. Here, 0.4, usually we pronounce it as 0.4 or 0.5. Okay. So, yahan pe 0.4 means 0.40 or 40. Okay. 25 is not bigger value than 0.4. In fact, 0.4 is bigger than 0.25. So be careful. Pronunciation, though I pronounce it as 0.4, but actually it is 0.40 or 0. You can say it as 0.400, 0.4000, any. Okay. Any number, no matter how many zeros you append, value wahi rehne wali. Right? So be careful. Aisa mat socho ki ye bada hai and this is smaller one. ये होता है बच्चे ऐसे मिस्टेक करते हैं दैट इज व्हाई आई हैव शेयर्ड विद यू ओके नाउ लेट्स सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज एन एम्प्लॉय प्लेज ओनली हॉकी मतलब ओनली हॉकी मींस हॉकी बट नॉट क्रिकेट करेक्ट तो एच इंटरसेक्शन सी कॉम्प्लीमेंट एंड एच इंटरसेक्शन सी कॉम्प्लीमेंट क्या होगा सपोज सी एंड एच मीन्स दिस पोर्शन एच इंटरसेक्शन सी कॉम्प्लीमेंट ओनली हॉकी ना तो फ्रॉम हॉकी विल सब्ट्रैक्ट सी इंटरसेक्शन एच तो दिस इज इक्वल टू प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ एच माइनस प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ सी इंटरसेक्शन एच Right? The rest of the part you can do, substituting the values. So answer hoga 0.5 minus 0.25, that is 0.25. Okay? 0.5 means 0.50. So 50 minus 25 is 25. So subtraction hoga 0.25. Okay. Second question kya hai? Only cricket. ओनली क्रिकेट मतलब यस प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ
सी इंटरसेक्शन एच डैश
करेक्ट सी इंटरसेक्शन एच कॉम्प्लीमेंट दैट इज इक्वल टू प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ सी माइनस प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ सी इंटरसेक्शन एच ठीक है यू कैन डू थर्ड क्वेश्चन एटलीस्ट वन ऑफ द टू गेम्स At least means what?
Union, right?
Union. C union H. Either cricket or hockey or both. दोनों में participate कर रहा है तो भी चलेगा, right? Only cricket कर रहा है, फिर भी चलेगा. ये क्या होगा? Here we have to apply addition theorem. It is probability of C. प्लस प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ एच माइनस प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ सी इंटरसेक्शन एच दैट इज 0.4 प्लस 0.5 दैट इज 0.9 माइनस 0.25 सो दैट इज 90 माइनस 25 इज 65 0.65 ओके 0.65 ओके एंड लास्ट क्वेश्चन डज नॉट प्ले Either of the game. Matlab? Does not play either of the game. That is complement of at least one of the two games. Okay. Matlab complement of C union H. So it is equal to 1 minus 0.65. So answer is 0.35. ओके
सर आपका वीडियो थोड़ा ब्लर दिख रहा है आई डोंट नो मेरा इंटरनेट शायद से नहीं है
नहीं नहीं काफी देर से ब्लर दिख रहा है
ब्लर दिख रहा है
यस यस
काफी देर से मुझे सेकंड सन भी लिखने नहीं हुआ था कल
मे बी मेरे एंड से कुछ प्रॉब्लम होगा एक काम करता हूँ मैं आई विल टर्न ऑफ माय वीडियो एंड टर्न ऑन इट अगेन अब कैसे दिख रहे हैं
दिस इज बेटर सर
ओके Actually, someone has requested yesterday about to upload the video of previous lectures. Actually, क्या हुआ है? From 20th of August, MS team had changed their setting. Okay. Somehow, in the transition period, I lost my all recordings. Okay. Till 21st of October. August recordings are available in the streams, but baad ke recordings available nahi hai. Subah mein wahi check kar raha tha. Yesterday evening also I checked, but somehow we lost the recordings of previous two sessions. So I morning maine wo setting phir se change ki hai. 20th August को MS Team ने setting change किए थे. Now we have to download the videos and then upload in the MS Team. Earlier वो automatic हो जाता था, but from 20th August they have changed the setting and because 20th August US के हिसाब से, तो हमारे यहाँ पे effect हुआ है वो 21st के बाद. तो 21st का lecture मेरे पास है, which I have already uploaded. But बाद के lectures available नहीं हो रहे, so I am extremely sorry about that. Now I have changed the settings. Let us see whether आज का lecture हो पाता है कि नहीं. I don't know. I am not sure, but let us see. Let's come to the point. Now it is visible, na?
Yes, sir. So but yes, the issues sir. Like sir, I had some doubts in as in permutation and the combination. मुझे starting का था, basic मुझे थोड़ा वो क्रैश कोर्स चाहिए था जो आप सिखाते हो स्टार्टिंग में, सो आई कैन नॉट मिस दैट. सो इसलिए रिकॉर्डिंग
में वी विल हैव अ सेपरेट सेशन फॉर दैट. अभी हम राइट नाउ विल फोकस ऑन कूल द प्रोबेबिलिटी पार्ट. ओके, ठीक है. लेट्स सॉल्व वन मोर क्वेश्चन, देन विल मूव टू कंडीशनल प्रोबेबिलिटी. एक और ट्राई कर सॉल्व करते. A factory employs both male and female workers. A factory employs both male and female workers. At random is male is 0.5.
Sir, please repeat.
The probability that a worker chosen at random is male is 0.65. That the worker is married, that the worker is married is 0.7. Is 0.7. And that the worker is married male, the worker is married male is 0.47. Is 0.47. Okay. And the question is, find the probability that a worker chosen at random, is first question, a married female. And second question, a male or married, both.
So can you repeat that?
Second question, a male or married or both? See, here the population is divided into number of subsets on the basis of two attributes. Okay, and the two attributes are first attribute is gender and second is marital status. Okay, so to solve such type of questions, we'll summarize the information in a tabular form. Okay, suppose gender main yahan pe leta hu, male, female. Okay, and marital status leta hu yahan pe, married. ये कैसे डिनोट करेंगे बिकॉज ये फिर सेम हो जाएगा. ओके, आई डिनोट मैरिड बाय एम ए एंड अनमैरिड बाय यू एम. फाइन. टोटल हियर एक्चुअली विल गेट बाय वेरिएट टेबल राइट बिकॉज हियर द पॉपुलेशन इज डिवाइडेड on the basis of two attributes. First is gender and second is marital status. Okay. Now, what is given? Given kya yahan pe? The probability that the worker chosen at random is male is 0.65. Male. Matlab, he may be married or may be unmarried. So, ye total is 65. Fine. Total number of males is 0.65. Second kya diya hai? That the worker is married is 0.7. Worker is married. Ab usme male bhi aa gaye, female bhi aa gaye. Okay. So total of married workers is 0.7. So yahan pe 0.7 ho gaya. Apart from this, aur ek information diya hai. Kya diya hai? And that the worker is married male. मैरिड मेल मतलब मैरिड भी चाहिए एंड मेल भी चाहिए. कितना है? 0.47. ओके, दैट्स इट. सिर्फ इतना इंफॉर्मेशन दिया है. ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस विल फाइंड द अदर इंफॉर्मेशन. नाउ वी नो दैट टोटल प्रोबेबिलिटी इज ऑलवेज इक्वल्स टू 1. सो सबका सम करेंगे, मतलब दिस प्लस दिस प्लस दिस प्लस दिस विल गेट 1. ओके. So given information I have written in blue color, right? Now jo blank say that we'll try to fill. See, we know that the total is always equal to 1. So male plus female should be equals to 1. So what should be this value? 1 minus
0.35.
That is
0.35.
Okay. Similarly, married plus unmarried equals to 100%. So this must be equal to 0.3. Okay. Again, male, total number of males, probability of males is 65.65, or 65% males are there, out of which 47% are married. Matlab baki bache kitne? 18%. Right? 18% are unmarried. Fine. अब ये total.
0.23.
Married males है 47% and total married है 70%. So this total, so married females must be 23%. Okay. अब ये मिल गया. Now we'll find out this. This total should be 35%. So ये होगा 12%. See, ये भी मैच हो गया. See, total, vertical total is also very matched. Okay. So here we have completed the table on the basis of given information. अब हमें क्या find out करना है? Probability that a randomly selected employee is a married female. Okay. So this is the required probability. Married female. मतलब प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ एफ इंटरसेक्शन एम ए, राइट, इट इज इक्वल टू 0.23. इंटरसेक्शन है ना फीमेल एंड मैरिड, राइट. सेकेंड क्वेश्चन थोड़ा सा ट्रिकी है. अ मेल और मैरिड और बोथ, मतलब क्या फाइंड आउट करना है हमें, प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ एम और एम ए, राइट. मेल और मैरिड और बोथ. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू एडिशन थ्योरम दिस इज इक्वल्स टू प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ एम प्लस probability of married minus probability of male intersection married. Okay. Now what is P of M? P of M, a total male lene, which include married as well as unmarried. So you get 0.65 plus married 0.7 minus married male M intersection MA, मतलब married भी चाहिए और male भी चाहिए, which is 0.47. Okay. ठीक है, calculation part मैं छोड़ दे रहा हूँ. सिंपल कैलकुलेशन है, 60 मतलब 23 आ जाएगा. ठीक है, तो दिस इज 23 0.65 प्लस 23 88, ओके 0.88, फाइन.
सर ऐसे सॉल्व कर सकते सर टेबल लगा के.
हाँ, आप फिर उसका क्या दूसरा कोई क्या तरीका. अब यहाँ पे दो एट्रीब्यूट थे इसलिए हमने टेबल निकाला, अदरवाइज टेबल निकालने की जरूरत नहीं ना. इफ वी आर डीलिंग विद ओनली वन एट्रीब्यूट, जैसे प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन में कर रहे थे हम. हाँ, प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन में भी कर सकते थे, हॉकी यस नो देन क्रिकेट यस नो, ऐसा कर सकते. ठीक है, यहाँ पे क्या होगा, हॉकी यस नो, यहाँ पे क्रिकेट यस नो, फिर आपको 2x2 टेबल मिलेगा, उसमें वैल्यूज आप सब्स्टिट्यूट करोगे तो आ जाएगा, राइट. ओके, नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस न्यू टॉपिक, कंडीशनल प्रोबेबिलिटी. कंडीशनल प्रोबेबिलिटी, ओके. I'll explain this with the help of one example. Consider an experiment tossing of coins, tossing of two coins. Okay. So, what is sample space concerning this experiment? HH, HT, TH, and TT. Okay. Now, if you ask, what is the probability of getting both heads? What is the probability of getting both heads? It is 1/4. Correct? पहला definition हम apply कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे. All outcomes are equally likely, and sample space is a finite, so we can apply classical definition. So according to that definition, probability is number of elements in event, both head, मतलब HH, एक ही event, एक ही element है, divided by 4, so 1/4. So, अगर आपको betting करना है, that both outcomes will be head, fine. So, आपके chances क्या है winning के? The chances of your winning of the bet is 1/4 or 25%, fine. But somehow, you came to know that the first toss resulted in head. Okay. आपको पता चला कि पहला जो coin toss किया था उसमें head आ गया है. Okay. So again you are betting on the same thing, both heads. So what will be the probability of your winning?
Half
hogi, correct? Because your winning depends on the outcome of second toss only. Okay, the outcome of the second toss is either head or tail. So yahan pe, if I denoted by B, what I am assuming that first trial resulted in head. So outcome, possible outcome kya ho sakte hai? Both head or head and tail. Okay, so in this case, your chances of winning is 1/2 or 50%. Correct? Concept samajh mein aa gaya? So here I have imposed one condition. And what was that condition? That first trial resulted in head. So if I impose condition on the first trial, then the probability of winning is 1/2, right? So this type of probability is called as conditional probability. Okay. Ab uska derivation formula here I'll give formula directly. Fine. So event A kya hai mera? When I'll win the bet, if both trial resulted in head, then I'll win the bet. Fine. So this probability is called as conditional probability, and it is denoted like this: P of A, that is probability that I'll win the bet, given that event B has already occurred. Okay. मतलब मुझे पहले ही पता है कि पहला trial, first trial resulted in head. Okay. If it is given that event B has already occurred, then what is the probability that I'll win the bet? Okay. So this is called as a conditional probability, and it is denoted by this symbol P of A, vertical line, strictly vertical line B. Okay. Isko read kaise karte? P of A given B. Okay. Probability of A given B. Iska meaning kya hai? What is the probability of occurrence of event A if it is given that event B has already occurred? Right? This is the meaning of conditional probability. Okay. And the formula for the same is probability of A intersection B divided by probability of B. So conditional probability of A given B is calculated with the help of this formula, probability of A intersection B divided by probability of B. Okay. Fine. Samajh mein aa gaya concept? Okay. Ek kaam karte, let's solve some examples. फॉर्मूला लिख लो आपको यूज होगा. प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ए गिवन बी इज इक्वल टू प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ए इंटरसेक्शन बी डिवाइड बाय प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ सी. सी अगर प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन हम कंसीडर करेंगे तो वी कैन इजीली वेरीफाई दिस फॉर्मूला. व्हाट वाज ए ओमेगा एच 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 टी टी एच एंड टी टी. फाइन. Event B, first trial result in head, matlab HH, HT. Okay, and event A, both trials resulted in head. Okay. So what is probability of A given B in this case? Probability of A intersection C, A intersection B kya hai? Only one. So its probability is 1/4 divided by probability of B. What is probability of B? 2. N of B is 2 divided by N of omega. That is 2/4. So this 4, 4 get cancelled. It is equal to 1/2. Okay. Fine. So let's solve some examples. Example, a pair of dice is rolled pair of dice is rolled. If the sum of 8 has appeared.
Sum of what, sir?
Sum of 8. दो डाइस थ्रो किए ना, सपोज आउटकम है 1 and 2, तो सम कितनी हो गई 3. तो यहाँ पे दिया क्या है, इफ सम ऑफ 8 हैज अपीयर्ड, फाइंड द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट वन ऑफ द डाइस शोज 3. वन ऑफ द डाइस शोज 3. ओके, सो यहाँ पे एक्सपेरिमेंट क्या है, two dice are rolled. So what is n of omega? Kitne possibilities hai yahan pe? Har ek dice ke liye 6 outcomes hai. Okay. So your outcome may be 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6 or 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, etc. Okay. Aise kahan tak chalega? 6, 6 tak. So, n of omega would be 36. There will be 6, 6 are 36. 36 different outcomes are possible. Right? You can list out all those 36, but yahan pe required nahi hai, so I'll directly write the number of outcomes in a sample space. Okay. Now, given event kya hai yahan pe? What is given event?
But the sum should be 8.
Huh. So I'll denote it by B. Sum should be 8. Matlab, kya ho sakta hai? It could be 2, 6 or 3, 5 or 4, 4, 5, 3 and 6, 2. Okay. So these are the five possibilities for which the sum of numbers appearing on the uppermost face is 8. Right. Now find out what is the probability that one of the dice shows 3. इवेंट ए क्या है आपका,
3, 5, 5,
वन ऑफ द डाइस शोज 3. वो 3, 5, 5, 3 इज एन इंटरसेक्शन. हमें एक्चुअली क्या करना है, इवेंट ए, हम इवेंट ए एंड बी सेपरेटली डिफाइन करेंगे. इवेंट ए क्या है, सम ऑफ 8 अपीयर्ड. एंड इवेंट इवेंट बी सम ऑफ 8 अपीयर्ड एंड इवेंट ए इज At least one dice shows 3. So, आपको ये भी हो सकता है ना, 1, 3, 2, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, अच्छा 3, 3 रह गया, 3, 3, 6, 3 और 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3 already we have taken, 3, 4. 3, 5 and 3, 6. Okay. Now here we want to find probability of A given B. Okay. What is the probability that one of the dice shows 3 given that sum of 8 has appeared? So according to the definition, it is equal to probability of A intersection B divided by probability of B. Okay. अब A intersection B में कितने common है? दो common element है. Right. So इसकी probability हो गई 2 divided by 36. Right. Set A and set B. Intersection of these two contains 3, 5 and 5, 3 only. So probability of A intersection B is 2 by 36 divided by probability of B. What is probability of B? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So that is 5 by 36 or it is equal to 2 by 5. Okay. Next example. तो आज हम क्या करेंगे? We'll solve examples based on conditional probability. Bayes theorem will start in the next session. Next example. A random experiment results in an integer outcome. Results in an integer outcome between 1 and 10. Between 1 and 10. In bracket, both are inclusive. Both inclusive. Okay. All numbers are equally likely. Let A be the event that an odd number occurs. And B be the event that a number divisible by 3 occurs. And obtain probability of A given B. Probability of B given A. Third, probability of A complement given B. And fourth, probability of A given B complement. Okay. So what is the sample space over here? Okay. So it is a sample space concerning experiment whose outcomes are natural numbers between 1 and 10, both inclusive. Okay. So my sample space includes 1 as well as 10. Okay. क्योंकि बिटवीन का मीनिंग अलग अलग हो सकता है वेदर टू इंक्लूड 1 एंड 10 और नॉट तो बिटवीन 1 एंड 10 मतलब 2 टू 9 भी हो सकता है बट हियर इट इज मेंशन्ड स्पेसिफिकली दैट बोथ आर इंक्लूसिव सो माय सैंपल स्पेस इंक्लूड्स 1 एज वेल एज 10 देन
इफ इट इवन मेंशन बोथ इंक्लूसिव सॉरी इंक्लूसिव तो अगर बोला नहीं गया तो बोथ इंक्लूसिव
हां अगर बोला नहीं गया है तो क्या करेंगे आपको जो भी लेना है मतलब सपोज आप 1 टू 10 लेंगे तो वहां पे मेंशन करो दैट इज योर अजम्पशन ओके अज्यूमिंग दैट बोथ 1 एंड 10 इंक्लूसिव सैंपल स्पेस इज लाइक दिस ओके और आप उल्टा भी अज्यूम कर सकते हो अज्यूमिंग दैट 1 एंड 10 आर एक्सक्लूसिव सैंपल स्पेस इज 2 3 4 अप टू 9 इवेंट ए क्या है An odd number occurs. So A होगा आपका odd number मतलब 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Event B. Event B क्या दिया है? नंबर डिविजिबल बाय थ्री अकर्स, मतलब 369. ओके, नाउ आपको ये फाइंड आउट करना है. पहला प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ए गिवन बी, दैट इज प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ए इंटरसेक्शन बी डिवाइड बाय प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ बी. ए इंटरसेक्शन बी, दो एलिमेंट कॉमन है 3 and 9, सो इट इज 2/10 डिवाइडेड बाय प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ बी इज 3/10, दैट इज 2/3. ओके, सिमिलरली फाइंड प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ बी गिवन ए. न्यूमरेटर वही रहेगा,
डिनोमिनेटर चेंज होगा, प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ
5/10 प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ए ना, गिवन इवेंट इज ए नाउ एंड द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ए इज 5/10 बिकॉज वी हैव 5 ऑड नंबर्स, तो आंसर होगा आपका 2/5. A complement given B. Okay, I'll write A complement over here. 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. Okay. So two complement. A complement given B. A complement intersection B divided by probability of B. So numerator would be 1/10 because A key element common, that is 6. Okay. So 1/10 divided by 3/10. It is 1/3. ओके, और आपको इससे भी निकाल सकते हैं डायरेक्टली, इसका कॉम्प्लीमेंट है ये. सी यू कैन सी दोनों के गिवन बी है, तो दिस प्रोबेबिलिटी इज 1 - प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ए गिवन बी. ओके, और एनीवे वैसे भी आंसर वही आया है. नाउ ए गिवन बी कॉम्प्लीमेंट, आई राइट बी कॉम्प्लीमेंट ओवर हियर. 1, 2, 4, 5, 7, 8, and 10. Okay, B complement consists of 7 elements. So, what would be A given B complement? Probability of A intersection B complement divided by probability of B complement. The probability of B complement is 7/10. What about numerator? A intersection B complement. 1 is in the intersection. 1, 7, 5. 3/10. 3/10, that is equal to 3/7. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. अ कार्ड इज ड्रॉन फ्रॉम एन ऑर्डिनरी पैक, फ्रॉम एन ऑर्डिनरी पैक ऑफ 52 playing cards. Of 52 playing cards. What is the probability that it is a king? It is a king, given that it is a face card. Given that it is a face card. Face card matlab? कौन कौन से कार्ड फेस कार्ड होते हैं? जैक क्वीन एंड किंग, जिनके ऊपर फेस है ना, जैक क्वीन एंड किंग आर फेस कार्ड्स. ओके, फाइन. सो व्हाट इज एन ऑफ ए ओवर हियर? एन ऑफ ओमेगा
52.
करेक्ट, because only one card is chosen. So n of a is 52. So there are 52 choices. So there will be 52 possible outcomes of an experiment. Event a kya hai, matlab kis cheez ki probability nikalni hai? What is the probability that it is a king? So n of a kitna ho gaya?
4/4.
हाँ, नहीं, that is probability. मैं ठीक है, probability लिखते हैं. ठीक है, चलिए. नहीं, n ही रहने देते क्योंकि हमें फिर काउंट करना है ना. ठीक है, I'll write probability over here. Probability of A is 4/52. Fine. Next, given event, it is given that the randomly selected card is a face card. So let us denote event B as selected card is a face card. So kitne face cards hain?
12.
3 in each suit and there are 4 suits. So ye ho gaya 12. Fine. So probability of B equals to 12/52. Fine. Ab find out kya karna hai? What is the probability that? What is the probability that a randomly selected card is king? Matlab A, given that it is a face card. Okay, so this is what we want to find. Okay, let's calculate. So ye kya hoga? Probability of A intersection B divided by probability of B. Intersection मतलब king होना चाहिए and face card होना चाहिए. ऐसे कितने हैं? 4. So 4/52 divided by 12/52. That is 1/3. Okay. कुछ क्वेश्चन मैं स्किप कर रहा हूँ. यू कैन ट्राई एट होम. आई शेयर दिस फाइल विथ यू. जो थोड़े से कॉम्प्लिकेटेड है दैट आई एम कवरिंग इन टुडे सेशन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. अ बिन कंटेंस 25 बल्ब्स. 25 बल्ब्स, 5 of which are in good condition. 5 of which are in good condition. And will function for at least 30 days. Ten of which are partially defective. And will fail in their second day of use. 10 of which are totally defective. And will not light up. Given that randomly chosen bulb initially lights, what is the probability that it still be working after 1 week? Okay. Question samajh mein aa gaya? See, we have to select one bulb randomly from a bin containing 25 bulbs. So n of omega is 25. 25 different possibilities are there. We can select any one out of 25. Fine. Then selected bulb may be a good condition bulb. So I'll denote it as G. Okay. If a bulb is in good condition, it will last for minimum 30 days. Okay. Now, how many such bulbs are there? 5. Okay. N of G equals to 5. Then, uske alawa hai, partially defective. उसको क्या लेंगे नोटेशन
पीडी पार्शियल डिफेक्टिव
यूजुअली हम पी यूज करते हैं प्रोबेबिलिटी के लिए
डिफेक्टिव डी डाल दीजिए
नहीं डी डिफेक्टिव भी है ना टोटली डिफेक्टिव भी है ना टोटली डिफेक्टिव 10 है पार्शियल डिफेक्टिव के लिए चलो ए भी यूज करते हैं ठीक है अब फाइंड आउट क्या करना है सो इट इज गिवन दैट रैंडमली सिलेक्टेड बल्ब इनिशियली लाइट्स अप ओके अब इनिशियली लाइट हो रहा है मतलब क्या है इट इज आइदर इन गुड कंडीशन और is partially defective. अगर वो totally defective है तो वो light ही नहीं करेगा. It will not light up. Correct? मतलब कैसे आप suppose किसी shop में जाते हो bulb खरीदने के लिए, ठीक है? तो आप वहाँ पे test करके लेते हो ना? So when you purchase, जब आप purchase कर रहे तब उसने test करके देखा तो वो light हो गया, ठीक है? But अगर वो partially defective है, then it will fail next day. Second day में वो खराब हो जाएगा. Fine. But it is given that the randomly selected bulb initially lights. Okay, so it is either in good condition or it is a partially defective. Right. It means that it is not totally defective. Now, the question is, what is the probability that it will still be working after 1 week? See, 1 week ke baad bhi wo chal raha hai, matlab it must be in good condition. See, agar wo partially defective hota to wo second day mein kharab ho jayega, right? But it is still working after 1 week. It means that it must be in good condition. So here we want to find probability of G given. What is given? Given kya hai?
Initially light.
Matlab, it is either in good condition or in partially defective. Matlab, G union A. Right? Or you can write it as D complement. It is not totally defective. Totally defective nahi tha, isliye wo light kiya na initially. So you can write it as D complement or aisa le sakte hain. Fine. So it is equal to probability of G intersection D complement divided by probability of D complement. Right? अब लकीली यहाँ पे क्या है, ये जो सेट्स है, दीज आर एक्चुअली म्यूचुअली एक्सक्लूसिव. ओके, मतलब सपोज अगर मैं वेन डायग्राम निकालता हूं तो एक तो हो गया गुड कंडीशन, एक हो गए पार्शियली डिफेक्टिव एंड सेकेंड इज टोटली डिफेक्टिव. ओके, ऐसा कोई यहाँ पे कॉमन नहीं है, इसलिए हम वो थर्ड एक्सियम यूज कर सकते हैं. राइट? Fine. So G intersection D complement. ऐसे कितने होंगे? 5 है ना? Good condition and not totally defective. ऐसे 5 है. So this probability is 5/25. And probability of D complement is 1 minus probability of D. Right? So that is equal to 5/25 divided by 1 minus 10/25, that is 5/25 divided by 25 minus 10 is 15, 15/25. So this gets cancelled. So probability is 1/3. Okay.
Just because sir common नहीं है इसलिए आपने ये लिया, right? सिर्फ probability of G ले लिया. अगर common होता तो sir फिर आपको मतलब पूरा करना पड़ता.
common होता ठीक, anyway हम क्या कर रहे हैं, D complement use कर रहे हैं. अगर common होता मतलब ये क्या है, G union A. okay, given event क्या है, G union A ना.
yes.
अगर common होता तो हमें एडिशन थ्योरम यूज करना पड़ता, प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ जी प्लस प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ए माइनस प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ जी इंटरसेक्शन ए. बट हियर ये एक्सक्लूसिव है, मतलब ये चांस है ही नहीं ना. देखो दो ही पॉसिबिलिटी, इट इज आइदर इन गुड कंडीशन और इट इज पार्शियली डिफेक्टिव. बट दोनों नहीं होगा, कोई बल्ब आपका पार्शियली डिफेक्टिव भी है और गुड कंडीशन भी, ऐसा नहीं हो सकता. तो दिस प्रोबेबिलिटी जीरो. ओके, तो अगर माइनस जीरो करेंगे तो दैट इज नथिंग बट योर थर्ड एक्सियम. इफ इवेंट्स आर म्यूचुअली एक्सक्लूसिव देन ये पीजी प्लस पीए हो जाता है, इट इज नथिंग बट प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ डी कॉम्प्लीमेंट. अगर एक्सक्लूसिव नहीं होते तो फिर यहाँ पे प्रॉब्लम आ सकता था. राइट? ठीक है, इट्स 10:22. So we'll stop over here. In next session, we'll start a base theorem straight away. Okay? I'm direct base theorem start karenge. have any doubt, aaj kya kar raha hu main, I'll share notes with you in the channel. So you try few sums on your own. Agar usme koi doubt hai to hum next session mein discuss karenge, right? Okay, so let's end the session.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, welcome.